number of different groups. I will explore the properties of groups. I will identify the special type of normal group. We saw some properties associated with normal groups, such as commutativity, energy. We are going to look at a situation where we join multiple groups in produce. We blend more than one group, join them together for this one. And that's what we call it. So, suppose AB groups. They pick two groups A and B. Now, the external direct product of group by definition is external direct of groups A and B can be defined as A times B, which is a set of pairs AB such that A belongs to A, B belongs to B. This is what we call external direct products of B. It takes on pairs of elements AB, such that A is an element of ABC. So you can see clearly now that you expect this at least to be bigger or larger than the constituents in scale. Where it combines the two elements of the representative ASP. So, in that order, you may also define like A1 times A2 times A3 times A3 times A2. It will be set of pairs A1, A2, up to A9, with AI in A, I, or some I from 1M. Isn't it? By extension, that's how it depends. Sometimes we say we, as the notation comes, we try to write like this before that I come on to this. Meaning the product of AI square I runs from 1 to N. What is clear that this one picks elements from the respective groups A1 to A. This is your what? Direct products. Now why do we need direct products? I think that's the question most important.
To construct one large, just like if you want to construct this block of classes, it's not possible to construct the other things, isn't it? So you can start constructing first class, second class, and then when you finish, you do the work and you surround it here. Or you want to build an estate, you cannot do it at once. Or you can start first house, second house, third house. Then when you finish, you build a wall and you say you have an estate. So that's what actually group theorists do. They look at small ones. But because the reason why you need small ones is that it's easier to handle. You can quickly see. If you are checking, you want to check a property. It's easier to check a property with a group with an additional element.
What do you see how the element is? Now you have a big group with thousands of elements. So the way you have it, you bring second one third, then bring them together. Yes, so it means that this is
this concept is important because it, the product will inherit the theoretic properties of the individual groups. So that, so motivation, well, this is like the AIs, if for example number one, if A, B and so on, whatever, are groups, then A times B will be group. So that means this program will inherit the properties. If A is a group, B is a group, then A times B is going to be a group. For example, again, you may also say that if A and B are not only group, but are normal. Normal. Maybe some good examples. Then it, that this implies that A and B will also be normal. Okay. So actually that's what it means. And so on and so forth. For example, number 3, you can also say that if A, B, whatever, are each finite, then what? A times B times will be a finite. And so on and so forth. So you can invent all these properties. And that is why, that is the motivation actually why we do this. I can quickly now see that we have a way of collecting these groups from one large group. And we now translate this individual process across. You may like to, if you wish, you may wish to clarify this by time. One is that you can contact by time. Before you can make it a lemma, but it's going to try to by time. What do I want to say? A, B. A and B is group. For example, A, B are groups. Imply groups. What it means is that these elements, for example, you know, you write A as A, A1, A2, and B. Suppose you have B, but B1, B2, you have to be M. Then you expect A times B in collection AI, EJ, for example, where IJ, I am from 1. What do I mean? Now you now compose the group theoretic properties. What do I mean? One has A and B as B. What do you say? You, so you want to say that A, this A has B is a group. And this is what you want to check. How do you check this? How do you be sure? How do you actually establish that this one is? A is a group. A is a group. We imply what? There exists E in A. Is it E? Suppose it's a multiplicative group, so let it just be.
One, so A will happen.
Says that so such that A is 1 plus 1 A is equal to A for any A. Also B is a group means what? There exists 1 in B such that 1 plus B is equal to B plus 1 is equal to B for any B element. This implies there will exist 1 1 in A times with 1 in A, 1 in what? I mean. So this implies what? A times B is what? Has identity. Has identity element. I think it's very clear. So it in, but it has, you can see that identity was inherited from the parables. This one was inherited from A. Second one was inherited from A. We have one. A. So that now, for example, so that 1 1 times A B will simply what? Be 1 A 1 B, which is equal to simply A B, and it's also equal to A B times 1 1, isn't it? Yes, because I am application in product group is non component wise, just like the vector spaces. So that's an answer. Okay. So you can take an element, secondly, okay. Since A is a group, then any element A you pick AI, let it. AI or A, there exists AI inbox also in A such that A inbox one, where one is the identity. Also, since B is A, since B is also A, then if you pick B in B, will imply that there exists also B inverse. Also in B, that B inverse will be 1, where 1 is a vector. Then, in that case, then A inverse, B inverse, will be in A times B. That is called the inverse or also in A times B. Now why is it called inverse? Because since A inverse A, B inverse, you apply it with A, B. You do components wise, this will give you A inverse A. Second one will give you what? B inverse B. And this will produce 1, 1. And we know what is the identity element of A. Is it the identity element of A times B? It's clear that this also means, this also gives you the same as A, B, A, must be, A must be, so also be the same formula. So that will still be A must be, B must, now will still be one more. So the identity, the uniqueness of identity, the embassy is also there's another source. So the next thing is to check the associativity to the followers since the RB is a rule. So this is the rule structure. Yes, this is actually a rule structure. So we can easily talk some of the rest. The RB are normal, any local service. You know, if the elements of the community related to that property is considered normal circuit. That's why it's called the YS. So if A is normal, A normal means what? A1, A2 will be the same as A2. That's the elements of the community. Or if we don't want to say about elements of this commutative, we say two elements, I'd like to be taken like this. A times B normal. Normal means what? A, B is equal to B, A. A and A, B. That's the meaning of. This is what I mean. So I'm going beyond the commutative. No, no. This is what I mean. Then B is no longer. Okay. So you take any two elements in that case. Maybe A1. B1 times A2, B2, and this will give you A1, A2, B1, A2. This will be the same as, so if we can now say this is A, and B times A, respectively, B1, B, times A1, which will give you what? B1, A1. And the second one will be what? B2, A. Now, we may wish to compare 1 and 2. That's your job. Compare. Oh, what did I say? Oh, sorry, it's a mistake. B2. Yes, sorry. So this is going to be B1, B2. B1. And this one will be
A1.
A1. Sorry. A1. So compare 1 and 2. That's your job. A1, A2, B1, B1. B1, B2. You want to say that these are equal. But you want to say that A1, 1 and 2. When it's equal to multiply what? Means what? This L, A1, A2, B1, B2 will be the same as B1, B2, A1. This is true if what?
family A. But A is normal. Maybe you suppose A and B, but A to be normal. A and B are normal given status. So that's me. That's therefore this implies A1. The order. That means the order. Because that's what we, this one only says the order. It means that the order is the same. A1, A2. We're not saying A1, A2 is equal to B and B, but so for writing A1, A2 first, then B1, B2 means the same as writing B1, B2, then writing A1, A2. So A1, A2 is A normal. This implies A times B will be equal to B times B. Because that's a property of normal. And this implies that the 2 hours are the same. Because this one, A times B is the first one.
Yes.
A1, A2. While B times A is the second one. So when we say this is equal to this domain, likewise, we also show that A is finite, B is finite, then A times C will be finite. So, but there is also a formula, for example. Now, if the cardinality of A is M, the cardinality of B is M, then the cardinality of A times B is going to be M times B. As the order, the number of elements in A and B. Because B is same as the respective elements. That we can also check. Quick example is you give some numbers. For example, for the number is 2, term is 3. Then we have A would be having 2 elements. A1. B would be having 3 elements. B1 and B2. Now what is A times B? A1. You look at the number of elements. What how much? So this is M. This is M. So that's the number of elements. So you discover here, cardinality of A here is 2. Cardinality of B here is 3. The cardinality of A times B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's 6. And 6 is 2 times 2, isn't it? So that means this formula is practically working. So that means also that from groups of 2 elements in elementary community, this is a bigger group system. Isn't it? Just like this is 10, this is 10, you have 100. So you can always begin to enlarge groups using this concept of products. I think
Any questions about this? So this is technically the meaning of a direct product of groups. And the next one will be it's a group action.
I should map, I want to map A and B come to A and send A as B onto the event because I want to call this projection.
Because why I don't call it projection? Because I'm projecting the image of a larger group onto just one. Larger group A onto just B. That's why I call it projection one. For example, the two of you in a household, maybe you have all these songs in your house,
and you are learning and say, okay, you say A,
so I represent family in company A, and you as MD there. B, go and present family in company B. You are the MD. So it's like you are representing the group. So you are projecting the image of the family. So you are like a representative. So we call this projection magic, that is. Yes, so what it means is that this matter will take pairs, so I will set a pair, AB, let me say it will take a pair, AI, BI, from here, and it will map it into just AI. This is the first pair of A. While pair of B will take what? This same pair AI, BI, because this has elements of, it has an element of A times B. We know. And it will map it into A. So, you may wish to investigate the properties of this margin, for example. You will discover that if you continue iteratively on the elements of AIs, which will be AI, BI, this will give you so pi of A ultimately, which normally takes space of AI, BI, will give you, ultimately will give you A, set A, because it's going to give you what? Pi of A on when you operate it on A plus B, it will be giving you what? Maybe A1, A2, up to maybe A, which is simply the group A. So this group A will give you, while the other one will ultimately give you this. The BIs. Because see, it will be like this. The actual elements will be something like this. Let me give you the actual elements. Something like A1, 1. A2, 1. A3, 1. And so, up to what? So it has fixed the B, but it is changing A by S. So ultimately this will give you just the A. Likewise, this one will give you the elements like 1, B1, 1, B2, 1, B3, up to 1, B1. And this is simply versus B. So what this means is what? That the value is so common
between these two projection matrix ones is identical. So the only element which is this pi's of A, pi of A, if you now take intersection, is pi of B. The only thing you find in common is what? The identity element. Only one way. Otherwise, the I's are always different because AI is different from BI. For any I. So today the values in the share of common will show up is 1. Like this margin, not here.
No. Here, when you cancel the equal sample,
equal sample, or not for the, or if any AI is not equal to this, AI is like any AI. This margin is 1 to 1 in respect of A. 1 to 1 in respect of A. Isn't it? So, it's like a small 2. And a small 2 is 1 to 1 to 1 to 2. And a small 2 in respect of A and A. And so on. So, we remember these considerations about the matrix. You can extend this now to A and B. This is just for two, for simplicity, but you can extend the product of AI, BI, B1, B. So you can continue to do this. The next thing is a good action now. By group action, we mean the action of groups on sets. So you have two fundamental structures here. You have, on one hand, you have set versus, we saw in what is it? Well, we had a relationship between group and group. Now we want a relationship. Our relationship, if you call it theta, is now between group and set. So it's like theta is going to mark G onto the I. Yes, where G is a group associated. When we have a matrix like this, we say we have a group. The actual margin theta is going to mark G times omega. And the non-elements of omega, where G is a root and omega is an empty it will mark a pair, so the elements here are in pairs. Actually, so theta will take pairs G and maybe alpha, and the ultimate image will be alpha. Where alpha G is an element of group, alpha is an element of one. Provide a theta such as one two properties that G one. Okay.
alpha of 1, these two conditions are what is okay. So provide these two conditions are actually satisfied, that means alpha acting on, being acted on by G first, then being acted by H, same as alpha being acted by G. Alpha being acted by what is alpha? Remember, alpha is an element of the empty set, while G and H are elements of G. So this is actually called group acting on set. Okay? Group acting on set. Remember, your group is your G, your set is elements of G as the G and H. Element of omega are your alpha. So it's like we have an element of group. Element of set, ordinary set, being acted on by
group. Okay. We shall verify that. G.
So it means, therefore, G is therefore a subset. Okay, which we normally represent like the same body, symmetry, same. Okay. Elements of make an empty element. So you have a non-empty set omega, and you take the elements of omega upon permutations so that they don't group themselves. So you now allow this group to act on the elements. Then you say you have a group. I'll give you an example. Let's suppose we take omega of T with the elements 1, 2, 3. It's just ordinary elements. But you can create a computation of omega td, permutation of omega td, called it st. St is then going to be the permutations 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, then 1, 2, 1, 3.
These are the elements of, this is a group number. Group of permutations of elements of omega. So, and I think you know how these elements come about, permutations. You know how you permute the elements of omega. For example, the first one says 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
And this is the identity element. 1, 2, 1, 2, 2. Isn't it? Is that common says what? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1. This is what this one says. 1 is mapped to 2, 2 is mapped to 3, 3 is mapped to 2. The 2 line notation. Okay, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 back to 2. It's a cyclic form, yes.
And this one is saying 1 to 3, 1 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1. Okay? And this one is saying line notation, this is 1 to 2, 2 to 1, and 3 is this. It doesn't go anywhere. And this one is saying 1 to 3, 1 to 3, 3 to 1, 2 is fixed. And the third one, the last one, this is saying 1 to 3, said 1 is fixed. 2 to 3, 3 to 2. And 2 line notations.
So these are permutations of element 1 to 3. You see, it's 1 to 3 that we are actually.
This is a group. This is a set.
So you may wish to apply. You may wish to apply this group. You may wish to apply this set omega. And try to see how this group acts on.
Look at that. So you may wish to compute these permutations.
If you do that, you pick elements one by one. Because on alpha has 1, 2, 3. So,
and you want this to be acted on by
Z G.
That means you have 1, 2.
Being acted on by elements of
the elements of G are simply 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3.
So you want these elements to act.
Yes.
So an element alpha 1 may be picked 1 and allow it to act 1 by 1. This will give you just 1 because 1 is identity element. You may also pick 1 and allow it to be acted on by element 1 to 3. 1, 2, 3. This means this says 1 is equal to 2. So this one will become 1. You may fix 1, allow it to be acted by 1, 3. Here 1 is more space, so it is tick. You may pick 1, allow it to be acted by 1, 2. 1 is tick, so it is 2. 1, allow it to be acted by 1, 3. And this is just tick. Pick 1, allow it to be acted by 2, 3. So 1 is fixed. This one will fix what? To see what is the place. So if you look carefully here, if you collect this, you are going to have a set 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1. So ultimately, this will give you just 1, 2, 3. It's hard to repetition.
The only elements I want to see is yes. Of up to 3, you want it to correspond. Like, you are going into the cycle 1, 2, 3.
For example, if you have to draw it like this,
this is 1, this is 2, this is 5.
I don't know if you draw it on this cycle.
This is 1, and this is 2, and this is 5.
The first one says 1 to 2. What? This is sorry. The first one says 1, 1, 2, 2 to what?
Okay. Then you stop here. That's the first one. One. The second one says what? Two. Start from two. From two to what? Three, then to what? Then to one. So, two, three, one. Two, three, one. The first one is one, two. The second is two, three. Later has this, this is what we call these orbits. It's like going around. That's it, that's what this is. You can do the same with two, you can do the same with three. So you are going to be producing orbits of two orbits. So this is what we call action. Work is now acting on this set and it's resulting in production of orbits. How to learn patient students are not